Hey guys, it's Peter, and welcome to my channel.
Peter likes books.
Well, when it's a Thursday and you have nothing to do, why not a book tag video? Like, seriously, get over it. But anyway, I'm so excited because, like, I have done so many book tag videos. I love doing book tag videos. I love A, being asked questions about myself because I B, like to talk about myself, and C, I love to talk about books. So book tag videos are kind of like, they're like all of those tied together. So I was looking through videos last week, and somebody that I follow just did the I Am The Reader book tag, and so I don't know who this originates from, I don't know who originally did it, but I had never done it before, and actually, I had never really seen a lot of people that had done it before, so what will be so funny is if I look through my videos later and I'm like, there it is, and I did it like 6 months ago, but I'm pretty sure I have never done this tag video, so I'm really excited about it, and I am just going to get right into what is the I Am The Reader book tag. Question number one, a word that describes being a reader. I would say passionate, okay? That would be my word for a reader. Like, I think readers, like, love to, like, meet new people, but maybe are sometimes shy because we like to meet characters. We love to get into other people's worlds. We're just passionate about life, and, like, books, I think, just, you know, reverberate that for us in the entire, in the entirety of the world. And I think a lot of us are very, very lonely people that, like, find a connection with characters in other worlds where we can come alive and live. So I love that so much. Let's see. Question number two. What's the very first book you fell in love with? The very first book I fell in love with was The Lonely Doll. And I actually read it on this channel, and I will link that video before. She was very, very, she had everything she ever wanted, but she was very, very lonely, The Lonely Doll. I used to read that book, like, so much when I was a little kid. I loved the book, The Lonely Doll, so much. Okay, hardcover or paperback? Paperback all the way. I love them. I love that right now I'm, like, really into those paperbacks that are, like, this size, you know? Do you know what I'm talking about? They're, like, between, like, an old-school paperback and, like, a hardback. That's what I like. I'm really into those right now. Okay. How has reading shaped your identity? I mean, my identity has, I think, 80% of my identity has been shaped, probably, by books. And, you know, whether they be fictional books or self-help books. When I was growing up, I tended to read a lot of books that had, you know, a lot of characters that developed my character, if that makes sense. I can remember, you know, my mom having me read a lot of books when I was in high school that she thought were important for my psyche or for growing up as a person. My mom was really big into that. My dad as well. But my dad was a little different. Like, he had me read books like As a Man Thinketh. Is that the book, what it's called? And, you know, other things like that. Well, whereas my mom had me read books like, you know, Eldridge Cleaver's, like, Soul on Ice and Black Like Me and To Kill a Mockingbird and books like that. Like, she was very into Who You Are as the Little Prince, you know, when I was younger. The Giving Tree, which everybody thinks is so corny, but I love The Giving Tree so much. It's one of my all-time favorite books. Other Places You'll Go. I mean, Dr. Seuss books always have such a great, you know, message in them, I think. Very kind of spooky, strange. Whenever I watch that movie, The Lorax, I'm always like, can you really imagine, like, if you lived in this world? You'd be, like, spooked out, like, for real. Anyway. Let's see next. What book do you read when you need to be comforted? It's an interesting question. Like, I'm not necessarily somebody that, like, goes to a book when I need to be comforted, which is really strange because I'm such a reader. Like, I typically go to a movie. Like, I go to, and it's usually something funny but adventurous, like this movie, like Adventures in Babysitting would be something that I would go to. But if I was gonna go to a book to be comforted, let's see. I'm, like, looking over my bookshelf, what I would go to, see if something just pumps out at me. Like, I'm not a big rereader, you guys, either. So I don't know that I would go to a book to be comforted. But I'm always, like, I would probably go to the book that I'm reading at that moment because it would allow me to escape. And I'm always reading a book or 10 and listening to a book or 10 on Audible. So, like, I mean, you know, that's just where I go to escape, is to read. So, yeah, I would probably just go to whatever book I was reading. Who taught you to be a reader, or did you do it all on your own? No, both of my parents were very instrumental in me being a huge reader, but definitely my mom. Like, when I was a little kid, my mom would always read me a nighttime story. I would be in the bathtub, and she would read books to me in the bathtub, typically about, like, fish and swimming and things like that, which I look back on, I think it's so cute. Like, very calculated how she did these things, you know, and, And then I can remember, you know, like her taking me to the library and getting my very first library. I can remember getting my very first library card. And, you know, like libraries were sacred places to my mom. You know, school libraries, college libraries. Whenever we would go visit a college, she would always like take me to the library. It was always like a place that she wanted to go to visit. So, and always like library bookstores were really important to her too. You know, like campus bookstores, college, I mean, not campus bookstores, but like college library bookstores, like where they would sell like old books. And then just like the library down the street, those bookstores. So like libraries were really, really important to my mom. You know, till the day that she died, like giving somebody a book and inscribing it was like her number one favorite gift. So my mom taught me how to be a reader. Let's see. Describe your dream reading lounge. Okay, so I was actually thinking about this. I love to read outside, right? But I think if I had like a screened-in porch that was like big, okay? And I mean like by 20 by 20. And then I have these huge just like green couches. I don't know why green, but like Kelly green and like very comfy, like a big L-shaped couch out there with plants hanging everywhere and like white lights just streaming like all over the place, right? No television and like tons and tons of white candles because I love to read while I'm, like their candles going. And maybe like I need something a little bit in the background, but not too much. So maybe like a little one of those like little waterfalls or something in the corner and like screens open so I can and open in the ceiling so I could see like the full moon and stuff outside, and then just tons and tons of throw blankets and pillows because it's just all comfy cozy in there like that. Yeah. What book changed the way you act or see the world? Well, I don't think this will be any surprise, and that's the last question. I don't think this will be any surprise to anybody that I have read the book, seen the movie, am obsessed with, love it so much, To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. It is hands down my all-time favorite book, hands down my all-time favorite movie. I love the movie more than I love the book, honestly. I love the character of Scout in the book. I love Gregory Peck as Atticus. When I read the book, I see Gregory, and I've read it many times, I see Gregory Peck as Atticus and Mary Badham, who played Scout. I see her as Scout. You know, I think it taught me the most about my life as far as how to treat people and also how to handle situations when people, you know, are cruel to you. Like, you know, turning the other cheek and, you know, trying to put yourself in somebody else's shoes when, you know, those kinds of things. So it's, the book is so, I mean, the fact that she wrote this book with no idea that it would be the great American novel and it ended up being the great American novel, I mean, really, let's be honest. You know, I mean, it's taught in every major school across the United States. I mean, it's just phenomenal. And I love Ghost at a Watchman. I know a lot of people didn't like it. It would make a great Christmas present for those of you that haven't read it. Ghost at a Watchman, which is the second one that she wrote that apparently she didn't want published. I think they go together so perfectly fine that... I love them together. I love them as a counterpart. I love them as a... I love Ghost at a Watchman as a closing to Kill a Mockingbird. They work perfectly together for me. So, yeah, I think that's it. I think that's it. I'm a reader. And I'll always be a reader, I hope. So, that sounded so dumb. I love you guys. Follow me on all my social media. It's all linked below. And I'm back here every day. I love you guys. Talk to you later. Bye.